classes. We have completed many classes like regarding CDC, Lin synthesis and all. And today I'm going to explain you regarding static and timing analysis, that is STA. This is a very, very, very important topic which we went to come for an industrial cope-up point, because the static timing analysis is very important to check the timing reports. If the timing reports were passed only, we can go for any further tape out or any other procedure. So this is static timing analysis is very, very important. So in this topic, what are all the topics I'm going to be discussed? First, I'll be discussing you regarding difference between a dynamic STA and static STA. Next, what is STA? Next, what all the steps were involved in STA? STA is nothing but the full form of STA is static timing analysis. Next, what all the inputs of STA we are going to do? Next, what are timing reports? Timing, how the timing report look like, and what are the parts present in the sections or else parts of timing reports? Next, slack, types of slacks, delays. Types of delays, what are the delays we are having? Next, what is clock skew, what is clock jitter, clock uncertainty, different types of paths is nothing but single path, multiple path, false path. All the paths will be coming under different types of paths. So today I'll be discussing only few topics. In these all the topics I'll be discussing only few, like 4 to 5 topics, and in the remaining classes it will be continued. So first, let me explain you what is the difference between dynamic and static. See, we are saying dynamic, static. We are having two types of analysis, right? Dynamic analysis and static analysis. So what are that? Let me explain. See, dynamic is nothing but it is applied in the spice level, or it is very accurate, and it doesn't have a it doesn't report any false error. But when we come for the static STA, it is very less accurate. And it cannot detect the timing errors, but we will be having a timing requirement or exceptions will be there in static STA. So that is why we are using the static STA, because we need some exceptions, right? As we are, the tool is doing all the work, and we don't know the particular value, or we don't know the particular point, or we don't know the particular answer. So we need some exceptions, or we need some requirements that is be done in the static STA. So dynamic STA analysis depends upon the vectors, or and it is also very slow process. That is, STA is very slow process. So we will be not using dynamic STA. STA is very fast, and it is an excessive process, and we will be getting the timing requirement for it is a better analysis. We get the static STA is a better analysis for the procedure. So that's why we are going to use only static analysis when we compare to dynamic. So why do always you prefer the speed or compatibility of any other procedure or any other material? Here already I told you that the dynamic will be a very slow process. But when we compare to the static is not a slow process, it is a fast process. So what we will be going with the fast process. That's why we will be comparing the static STA, or we are doing the static STA in the industrial process. So you may have a question like, why do we use a static STA? So here is the answer. Why is static analysis? What is a static? Static analysis is nothing but is a method of determining the circuit with timing constraint without simulating. Static STA is nothing but what? It is a process, or it is a method. Timing constraint, whether the circuit is met with the timing constraints or not, it will check without simulating. That means before simulating whether the circuit or whether the program or whether the design met a timing constraints or not, to check that we will be using the static analysis. And next, what are the important points? It's much faster than the dynamic. That's why we will be using static. Next, the vector generation is not at all required for the static analysis. So here you will be having a question like, why is the preferring dynamic static STA? Dynamic STA, why do we prefer a static STA? Here you can answer that when we compare to the dynamic, static is very fast.
Your voice is bilkul dumb, yeah. Like, voice is not coming. Just speak faster, a little bit.
Now is it clear?
It is now clear.
So you may have a question like why do we, instead of using dynamic, why we are using a static? You can answer that static is a very faster method, and here we can know whether the circuit is meeting timing constraint perfectly or not without simulating. So that is why we are using, that is the main purpose we are using a static STA. Next, define STA. So what is an STA, and main, what is the purpose of using STA, we should know, right? So we are knowing like what is CDC, what is the purpose of CDC, what is link, what is the purpose of link. In the same way, so for doing any work, we should know what is the purpose. See, now I'm explaining you what is the purpose of it. I mean, to understand and to go for an next level. In the same way, what is the purpose of doing STA? STA is nothing but it is a method of adding the net delay, cell delay, path delay. So what will happen in STA, we will be adding all the delays, net delay, cell delay, path delay. So in the going classes, you will understand what is net delay, what is cell delay, and what is path delay. Then the what this STA tool does, it will analyze all the paths, each path from start point to end point. So this is the main purpose of STA. What is the main purpose of STA? The main purpose of STA is adding all the delays. Either it is a net delay, cell delay, path delay. It will add all the delay and it will put to the tool. So what the tool does, it will analyze. What the time, the tool will analyze the report from start point to the end point. So that is the main purpose of the STA. Here you may have a question like what is a start point, what is an end point. When you go for an analysis of timing report, there I will show you what is a start point, what is an end point. Nothing but where the clock start and where the clock end. That is known as a start point or end point. You can also knew that start point is nothing but source, end point is nothing but destination. So this is the main purpose of STA. So what does STA do after that? It will analyze the start point and end point. So the first, what the STA does, STA, it will calculate the path delay. I told you like net delay, path delay, everything delays, no? So what the first does, the tool or the first STA does, what it does, it calculate the path delay. Next, based on the path delay, it creates some circuit, whether the circuit meeting the timing requirement or not, it will check. So what the first step involves? First step, nothing but STA, it calculates the path delay. What it does, it calculates the path delay. Based on the path delay, whether the circuit is meeting for the timing requirements or not. Meeting the timing requirements are nothing but meeting the slack. Whether it is meeting the slack or not, it will check. That is the first step of STA. Next, what is the second step of STA? In the second step, what it will do, it will analyze the timing of circuits and it will verify in which particular or in which frequency it is working. That is the main purpose, and that is the main functionality which is done by STA. These are the two main important points. What the first STA does? STA does first, it will check, it will calculate all the path delays. So after calculating all the path delay, it will check for the timing requirement, whether the circuit met a timing requirement, whether the circuit met slack or not, it will check. So after checking, if the circuit met the slack, it will check whether in which frequency, in which particular frequency it is working. So these are the two main methods which the tool of STA does. Next, main step of STA. So I am saying that STA will work like that. So each and everything, each and every instrument or each and every tool will have some basic few steps, right? In that here, STA are having three steps. First, what the STA does, it will break the design into set of timing paths. See, we will be giving the tool, we will be giving some netlist, or we will be giving some RTL code or RTL design. So what it will do is, what the STA tool will use, this STA tool will break the design break the netlist into set of timing paths. Because here the STA mainly work on timing paths, so to get easy that it will break the design into some timing paths. So after breaking down, what the STA does, it calculates the delay of each path. So for each timing path, what the delay is having, it calculates. What happens? First, it breaks down the design into set of timing paths. So after breaking down the timing path, what it does? It will calculate the delay of each path. That means the breakdown paths were there, no? For each path, it will calculate the delay. So after calculating what it does, it will check for the timing constraints, whether they are met or not. That means timing constraint, it will check for the timing report. Timing constraint, how can we see that whether the timing reports met or not, means whether the slack met, whether the slack meets a value, we can say the timing constraints were met. Whether the slack doesn't meet a value, we can say that the timing constraints were not met. So these are the main important steps which the STA tool does. What it does, it first it breaks down the design into set of timing paths. What it does the design, it will break the design into timing paths. Then after what it does, it will calculate delay for each path. For each timing path, it will calculate the delay. And what the third step does, it will check all the, after doing checking all the path delay, it will go for checking the timing constraints, whether the timing constraints are met. Important steps of STA. So I'm saying that inputs we will be having. So what are the inputs of STA? Here we are having inputs and outputs. Were there in this picture, you can observe. For STA2, after synthesis, we will be having some gate level netlist, right? So that gate level netlist is given to STA, and library is also given to STA. So what are the outputs we will be having? BC constraints, we will be having RC constraints and STF. These are the outputs for STA. And what are the inputs? Gate level netlist, libraries are the input for the STA. Here you may have two questions. What are the inputs of STA and what are the outputs of STA? So what you can say, inputs of STA in the sense gate level netlist and libraries are the library files are the inputs of STA. What are the outputs? DC constraint, that means design constraints, RC constraints, all will be the outputs of STA. So this is an introductory topic of STA. So what all we have discussed in the today's class. First, what is STA? What are the purpose of STA? STA is nothing. What it does, it will break down the design into timing paths and it will analyze the timing for each and every path. So what is the main purpose of STA? The main purpose of STA is nothing but adding the net delay, cell delay, path delay, everything. And it checks for the timing path from end point to the start point to the end point. So here we are having two steps, like what we do is first STA calculate the path delay. Based on the path delay, it will check whether the timing constraints are met or not. After timing constraints met or not, it will verify in which frequency it is working. Next, what are the main steps for the STA? The main steps for the STA is it will break the design into sets of timing path. It will break down into set of timing path. Because it becomes very easy for the tool, right? So after breaking down what it does, it will calculate further delay of each path. In each path, how many delays were there? For that, it will calculate. Next, after calculating the delay, what it does? It checks all the path delay, whether all the paths were meeting timing constraints or not. Here, meeting timing constraints are nothing but whether they are meeting slack or not. Slack in the next topic, when I go for the next topic, I will tell you what is slack and what are the types of slack. How can we check in our timing analysis, timing report, whether the slack met or not. Everything I'll be saying in our next class. So this will be an introductory class. If anyone have any doubt, you can just ask me a question so that I will clarify you. If anyone have any question, you can just raise me a question. I'll let clarify. Just this is an introductory class. In next class, you will be having how the timing report look like and what are the sections. The timing report contains many sections like start point, end point, and in which path the clock is passing. and what all the information, data arrayed will be there, data required will be there. In data arrayed, what all will be there, how, what are cells, what are net cells, what are LVT cells, everything will be there in the timing report. That will be cleared in the next classes.
Yeah, so thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.